Krishna, we all start today a series of video talks on soulful japa, and it is going to be basically following the japa modules that I have posted in Telegram and WhatsApp group. So today we'll be talking about module 1 and module 2, and also I'll take question and try to answer these questions on these two modules. So the module 1 is about a great news in modern times. That great news is about the incarnation of the Lord is present on the earth today. Just like we say 5,000 years back, Lord appeared in Vrindavan, and 500 years back, Lord appeared as Bhaktavatara in Navadvip. In the same way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Kalikale Krishna Nama Rupa Vatara. He revealed this great secret that Krishna has incarnated in his name. And specifically Chaitanya Mahaprabhu spread the form of the name Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So Lord, in this particular form of Hare Krishna Nama, we'll refer to this avatara as Nama Prabhu. Hare Krishna Nama Prabhu. Every incarnation does specific leelas. So naturally we expect, just like Krishna came 5,000 years back, so many leelas he did. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, he did so many leelas with his devotees. In the same way, Nama Prabhu is also engaged in unlimited leelas on this earth right now. Thousands of devotees, they are participating in this leela. Participating means just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he gave out his mercy to so many living entities by distributing the holy name. In the same way, anybody who has received this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, fortunate to receive this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, and especially to follow a pure devotee of this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, like His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, is really very blessed, and they are very much part of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Leela, Krishna's Leela, Nama Prabhu's Leela. So we should feel very, very blessed in the modern times if we have got an opportunity to know and associate with the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. And what is the specific leela of the Hare Krishna Mahamantra? What is the specific leela of Nama Prabhu? The specific leela of Nama Prabhu is that when you chant the Hare Krishna Mahamantra with your tongue, with your material tongue, the Lord descends into that sound. The Hare Krishna Mahamantra, the spiritual sound, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. There is a spiritual sound that we chant with our tongue, because the tongue is material. It's a material sound of matter. And in that sound produced by matter, the matter vibration, into that sound, a sound from the spiritual world, Shuddha Nama, Nama Prabhu, he takes an avatara and enters into this sound. And this sound is no longer an ordinary sound. The sound that you generated with your material tongue is no longer an ordinary sound. And that's called Shakti Avesha Avatara. That sound of the Lord, his leela continues. First he descends into the sound. When you hear that sound, the Lord enters our ears and then into our heart. and these leelas continue. What is the leela? After he enters his heart, the Lord is like the sun of Sachit Ananda. Just like sun is the brilliant light and heat, in the same way, Lord is a brilliant sign of Sachit Ananda. His Sachit Ananda energies flow into the soul when the Nama reaches our heart. And this way we become purified. Our heart becomes purified. Sat means eternity. Chit means pure knowledge. Who I am, who is God. And Ananda is experience of love and pleasure in serving the Supreme Lord. So Lord's incarnation as Nama Prabhu means he descends into the Nama that you chant with your tongue. Then through the ears, he enters our hearts. And in the heart, there is something called Chetodarpanam happens. Our hearts are cleansed of ignorance because the name of the Lord is pure knowledge. That pure knowledge goes inside our heart and it churns our chitta, our consciousness, our memories, everything. It cleanses. And then we experience what is self-realization and God-realization. So this is the specific leela of Nama Prabhu. Now today it is happening all over the world. And everything that has happened in your life is not as important as receiving this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. It is the greatest blessing to receive this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra and to serve the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra every day. And this Nama Prabhu was taken all over the world by none other than Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Just see, Nama Prabhu is a present incarnation of Lord Krishna on this earth. He is performing his leelas in thousands and thousands of souls, in relationship to thousands and thousands of living entities who are all chanting Hare Krishna. And the leela is that of Chetodarpana Marjanam, purifying and awakening their Krishna consciousness. So we should feel just like if somebody told that, you know, you were very much part of Krishna's leela 5,000 years back, how will you feel? Oh, that's great. Really, what was I? They'll say. The same way, we are all having the same good fortune. Out of 7.7 billion people on this earth, few people have got this great opportunity to vibrate the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra on their tongue, to welcome the Nama incarnation, Nama Prabhu, and to get the association of the Supreme Lord in the form of his Nama. So this is a way we should see. Just like if you say Krishna is 5,000 years back, he came, and we, on the globe, there is the Supreme Lord present. That's how we would say, oh, Krishna, he's there, he's born there, and he's doing his leelas there. Exactly in the same way, now the Lord is more liberal, not Vrindavan. On every tongue, he is ready to come. And when you chant, he comes. Therefore, he's called Namo Mahavadanyaya, the most merciful incarnation of the Lord. Just like if you want to see Archavigraha, you go to a temple and have darshan. But here, simply vibrate your tongue. God is there present on your tongue. And then that is the greatest fortune of people of Kali Yuga. And Prabhupada was the chosen devotee of the Lord who took this name all over the world. Once Prabhupada was asked, Srila Prabhupada, if Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted his name to be spread all over the world, why didn't Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself go to the Western world? Why didn't he himself go all over the world 500 years back? Srila Prabhupada laughed and said, yes, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to give that credit to me. So Srila Prabhupada actually was blessed by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to take this nama all over the world. And when you are in Vrindavan, you should, is something very important in this connection of Nama Avatara, I want to say, is Srila Prabhupada, before he went to America, he stayed in Vrindavan for 6 years in Radha Damodar temple. And that Radha Damodar temple is very much part of the leelas of the Lord. Lord Krishna, it's one corner of the Seva Kunj where Krishna performed his rasa dance. And that's Radha Damodar temple is a location where Rupa Goswami Samadhi is there, Srila Jiva Goswami Samadhi is there. You are all aware that our leaders of our parampara are the six Goswamis, the original leaders, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu directly instructed them what is Krishna consciousness, the entire science of Krishna consciousness to the six Goswamis. And the six Goswamis, they prepared all this literature which you are enjoying today, which Prabhupada has translated and Prabhupada is further writing. And all this knowledge is coming from the six Goswamis. And the leader of all the six Goswamis was Rupa Goswami. And Rupa Goswami's Samadhi is situated in Radha Damodar temple. And Prabhupada spent 6 years staying in Radha Damodar temple. Across the window, he could see Rupa Goswami's Samadhi. And he was intensely praying to Rupa Goswami's Samadhi. And he was intensely praying to Jiva Goswami, Rupa Goswami. And he had darshan of Rupa Goswami and Jiva Goswami live. Though 500 years back, they had left this mortal body. But they appeared to Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. They blessed him and empowered him to write about Krishna consciousness and preach all over the world. So this Hare Krishna movement is directly an expansion of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the six Goswamis, and that is how this movement is spreading all over the world. So we are all very fortunate to have this kind of an opportunity to chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Now, the most important thing, the Lord has appeared, he has incarnated. Once he has incarnated, we need to, we know that the Lord is present before us. When he is present before us, we have to receive him properly. We have to honor him properly. And how do you honor a sound? By attentively hearing the sound, chanting with devotion and receiving him with relish, happily, heartfully, we should receive the avatara. So Srila Prabhupada, basically now our challenge before us, Lord has incarnated, he is on my tongue, he is ready to go into my heart and cleanse my heart. But then, how effectively this happens depends a lot on whether you allow the holy name to go inside your heart. The Lord is on the tongue, but will you allow yours? There is a way, there is a particular consciousness by which the Lord goes into our heart. So this Soulful Japa series, I called it soulful because we have to soulfully receive the Lord and we have to soulfully serve the Lord. And what is this soulful receiving, soulful welcoming and soulful association of the Supreme Lord in the Nama form? That the series of this we will discuss in more and more videos. Thank you for being with me today. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss any updates.